Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. Let's once again give a hand again to RIT Locuno for such a powerful word. Mercy, mercy, mercy. It reminds me of one of those restaurants you go to and on the high end, plush, real nice, but they give you a little bit of food. You know, they give you a little bit of food and it tastes wild. So you always sort of, you know, you eat it, but you got to eat some bread with it and drink some water and stuff to really feel satisfied. Such a powerful message. So when she was to the end, I said, well, not already. Where did it go? This was a very encouraging and challenging message. And I want to do a covering prayer over RIT as she has given herself to be an instrument and a vessel fit for use and has brought forward a mighty timely message that anybody, no matter where you're at in your spiritual walk, can identify with this message and take something from it and understand what God is saying to you personally. So let us pray. Father God, to you be the honor, the glory, and the praise. Thank you for RIT Locuno. Thank you for her example. Thank you, Lord God, for her giving of herself so that the Holy Spirit can breathe on her and give her this message for us, for this day, for this week, for this month, for our life, so that we will truly let our light shine. Thank you for using RIT. Continue to restore her this day and continue to make her fit as she deals with her maintenance room and gets ready to continue to let her light shine. Renew her light, God. Continue to strengthen her beacon, that she will be able to use for you, and that in all things she will receive the honor and the glory from her life. Bless her and restore her, I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm going to invite Pastor Seaman at this time to say, first of all, a special covering prayer over these two mighty women that are right at the finish line of delivering these babies. I'm talking about Sister Ashley and D.I.T. Shay. And this is going to be an opportunity for Pastor to do a special prayer because I know you guys are right at the finish line right now. And we want Pastor to do a covering prayer over you. And then she'll give her remarks after that with respect to the message. Pastor Seaman.
Amen. Amen. God bless you, Pastor Randy. And before I go into any comments, I do want to give this prayer. Let's go to God in prayer on behalf of our sisters. Amen. Father, we do thank you. God, you are the giver of life. And because of that, God, even as our sister Ashley and our D.I.T. Lachey, as they are about to, I would say, echo your heart in bringing forth life, we now pray for them. We pray for them spiritually, physically, emotionally. God, that at this crucial, beautiful time, that you will surround them, God. Let there be unusual glory moments, God. Let there be testimonies that they know that you were in the room with them, that your presence was felt, your presence undeniable. And God, we pray for the little ones that are to come forth, that as they travel from an unseen place into this seen place, that God, you would allow them, even in the way that you deal with the little ones that are born, to understand that they have been born with a purpose. God, I pray that purpose, as it were, hallows or hangs over them as a mantle, that as they are born, that we know that your purpose, plan, and destiny will unfold. Again, God, we pray over our sisters. We bless you for the labor that they give to the kingdom. And Father, that this will be translated into this labor moment of coming and bringing forth. Father, we thank you for their spouses, that even as they take care of the little ones and are there at the hospital and are concerned about their wives, that this is as it should be. And that even in this moment, they will be drawn to know, who is this God? Who is this God of miracles, signs, and wonders? Oh, God, I pray that in this year, 2024 and beyond, that it will be known why these two little ones had to be born to grace this earth. God, be with them. Give them that even Holy Spirit boldness. that supersedes any other type of feelings. My, my, my. God, you have your way, and we await to hear of the delivery, the arrival, the announcement of children that shall be raised in your care. So, God, we give you glory. We give you all honor and praise. In Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen. And we pray for the gynecologists, those ones that are in the labor room. Hallelujah. Let the Holy Ghost, my God, let the light shine in there. Hallelujah. That they sense that this is different. Soak them, Holy Ghost. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There they are. They're my mamas. I'm excited. Let the pastor know when the babies are born. Amen. Isn't that wonderful? We celebrate life. We celebrate life. And I respect you both too. I really do. So again, I greet you in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thankful for the Trinity, God, the Father, Son, and blessed Holy Spirit. You know, the Holy Spirit is just so wonderful because he just speaks to people and they have just delicious stuff. So this past week, you know, some more's got a story, but it's coming in. This past week, I did scallops. I said, these are relatively big scallops. But then I had to thaw out some other scallops. They're like three times the size of the first scallop. And I say, I'm going to have some. Because when I ate the first scallops, I was like, they're already going. It was like one gulp and they were going. They were too small. And so I'm laughing at that because that's what Pastor Randy was saying. This was gourmet scallops, y'all. I never used to eat seafood by anybody past the doors. But I've got these large scallops that I thawed out. This meal was, it was very tasty. Very tasty. And I do want to congratulate you. It's not an easy thing to captivate me to a point. And you did that. Now, I don't know how, but I've got to get around to all the lighthouses in Bermuda in the next week and a half. I've got to take footage. I've got to go up to the top of one. I'm driven. I'm driven. I'm driven. Now, I'm going to sing a little bit here because the first time, I think I was around 10, 9. The first time ever, my mom, you know, they had a family thing in church and hurry up, I'm going to sing, you know, and I remember we had a picture of a lighthouse. And so every time when we sang the word lighthouse, I think I held up the lighthouse. Hello, somebody. But the song went like this. I'm just going to sing a little bit of it. There's a lighthouse on the hillside that overlooks life's seas. When I'm tossed, it sends out a light that I might see. And the light that shines in darkness will safely lead me home. I thank God for the lighthouse. Something, something, something. Anyway, you get the point. I would have looked it up if I knew I was going to sing it. It took me back to that song that has really, R.I.T. Laquita, guided my life. We came second. We should have come first. I knew it then. But that was church politics. I'm not going to get into it. Myself, Raymond, and Allison. I knew it then. You see, I have not just become who I am. Because we had church going. This lighthouse. Let me tell you something. You spoke so many volumes in this message. It's ridiculous. So, talked about the beaten beacon doesn't weaken. A dull light won't cut it. I think it's beautiful how you laid out the different areas of the lighthouse. You know, the staircase, the watch room, the main room, and then the cupola. Oh my, oh my. And you stated how the lighthouse provides hope because of the rough times. Well, there is no rougher time than the time that we're living in for the church. You know, out in America, they're trying to ban now the Bible because they say the Bible is anti-Semitic and talks against the Jews. Listen, I'm telling you, we've got to shine. I'm going to speak to that in a moment. Jesus, he is our lighthouse, you know, the holy upkeep of the lighthouse. What? The holy upkeep. You know, we're got to be the maintenance person. Nobody else can do it for you. You better be in your own watch room. You better walk up your own staircase. If you, what? You can't blame anybody else. But they weren't. What were you doing in the lighthouse as the lighthouse? And you talked about the cupola allowing air and light into it. Yeah, you're right up my alley. You talk about the lens allowing basically for magnification. I felt like falling out, but I couldn't. I can't fall out. Very challenging. I'm going to say something in a moment. The Holy Spirit illuminates the word of God. It shines forth. Again, I've got a question. Is the church the lighthouse? We know she's supposed to be. Daily maintenance needed. The staircase, climbing to that beacon, that tower, getting up there. There you mentioned, I never want to be accused of having a low beam pulse. Never let it be said of you. They ain't that serious. Ain't no matter. You can say anything in front of them. Then your point two, walk into the light. Empowered. And then we as children of light, that was the thing right there. Kingdom stewardship. If your eye offends you, pluck it out. Hold up, semen. No, this is just love. It's love. This is diversity, equity, and inclusion. No. We're not including everything in this lighthouse. Because if I see through I'll give you an example. I wear contacts. Right? When I go to my optometrist, right? They're like, you need a new pair of contacts? I'm like, no, these are last years. I only wear them on a Sunday. So all my hours I got to make up on a Sunday. Some people wear them every day. But here's my point. If you ever put them on and you haven't cleaned them, soaked them in the right solution, they can be cloudy. That means everything that you see is through a cloudy lens. And it's irritating, you know? I carry my glasses in case I ever have a moment. Because that would irritate you to view everything through a cloudy lens. Now, come on, church. Come on, people of God. We are the church. We are the lighthouse. And the question is, are we manifesting ourselves through a cloudy lens? I'm going to say something. That was a question. I'm lingering it. Let it linger. Because again, if it offends you, pluck it out. Whatever causes my light not to reflect the light is an offense to God. Say something here, Seaman. Love you, but listen to me. I would rather offend you than God. Come on. Hey. That sounds so vicious, isn't it? But it's the word, you know. It's the word. When the light shows up, the light doesn't say to darkness, I'm darkness, I'm here now. The light doesn't say to darkness, put up your holy finger. Do I have permission to make a statement? The light dispels darkness. Glory to God. I ain't asking for permission. I'm not asking if I made you happy. I will do as God told me to do and be confident in that, to know that when I stand before him, I did not misrepresent the light of who he is. That's a church right there. And I don't mean Shekinah Worship Center. I mean whoever is that way. I am clear. Shekinah is not the end all be all. It's all in the name of Jesus shining forth. Then we came to point three. This is where I want to say what I want to say. You talked about a call to action, accountability, show forth. So my question, as was asked, what are you showing forth? Then I wrote down, when you was talking about that RIT, Sister Laquita, I wrote, the fruit will speak. And then your next scripture verse came up, talking about no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness. I say, yes, that's what I said. Seven church right there. Because then the next word in that scripture said, reprove. See, we don't want reproving. Seeming, you're too passionate. Seeming, you're just too much. You're just too. I am reproving. I tell you every week, Bermuda hears me every week. I hope I make some people mad. If you're not mad now, I ain't done my work because I'm reproving you. That's right. Now watch this. Now here's the love. Remember, God chastens, he reproves those he loves. And so my reproving, reprove, is because I want it to be proven again that you are who you said that you are. And it only can be done as we shine forth the light of God's word. And so let light shine that they see our works and they glorify you, God. So here's my question. Why? I'm going to read slow like I did when I was in infants 1 and 2. Why is the world not turning to God? Because the church busy blinding each other with their light to each other. I can't stand you. Blah. I don't like you. Blah. We're busy blinding each other while the world goes to hell. That's why we got to get out and do the Great Commission. You got your Holy Ghost? Today's Pentecost Sunday. Well, that Holy Ghost is to get you out of each other's sight. Did they stay in the upper room? I say, ooh, oh, this is where God touched on. We're always going to worship her. Whoa. Isn't that something that Jesus said? Don't stay here. Don't stay here. Go. Go to your house, their house, every house. That's basically what he said. Because if not, let me say this, RIT, if not, we try to make our lamp a light. Oh, come on, I want you to picture it. The word of God, which is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. It's a lamp to my feet so that I can know I'm doing right. So when I take the pathway to invite the world in, it can be trusted. But what I believe too many churches are doing is they think the lamp to their feet is also the light. So it's all about them. No, it's all about Jesus. And I need to hear churches, I would think, who said that today is Pentecost Sunday and Jesus is the light of the world. Why is the world so much darker? Because the church has become quiet. She has shut down her lighthouse. She has said the lighthouse is too old fashioned. We don't need that anymore. We got technology now. We got radars. We got Wi-Fi. I'm telling you something. We need a lighthouse, not Wi-Fi. Ask yourself why and get out there and do what you have to do. All right, so a beautiful word. You see, you're like, Pastor Seaman still talked as long and the sermon wasn't even as long. She still talked. That's what I do. I have too much fun with this. Listen, shine forth, everybody. Shine forth, continue to shine forth, challenge yourself always. God is good, and Jesus deserves us not weakening the beacon. Oh, no, let's rhyme that. Not weakening the beaconing. Okay, there you go. I'm done. Blessings abound. My apologies, Pastor Randy. I got so much into everything. I didn't greet you, and I apologize for that. God bless you, sir, and for Reverend Eunice. God bless you. I'm just jumping into the word because you talked about the meal. So I went. So this is your fault. I forgot. Look at that house. She blamed him. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. It's mine. I honor you, sir. I'm thankful. And RIT, Sister Lupita, you've given much food for thought. And I'm telling you, woo, the cupola. I'm never going to forget that. So I'm going to go lighthouse hunting. And you'll see me. I'll put something together. God bless you again. And blessings abound. Thank you, everyone.
Man, come on and put our hands together for our covering pastor, Maria A. Seaman. Oh my goodness. Commentary on the commentary, because this is just so delicious. And what's a side that goes with scallops? What, shrimp scampi or something? Well, that was the scampi, I guess, if RIT Laquita gave the scallops. So yes, let us remember Our land should always be clear. God's word chastens and reproves those who he loves. So, Pastor Seaman, thank you for your wonderful commentary. Always a blessing. Always just that additional in our message. So we just give God thanks for you. And yes, continue to be that voice that can be heard to reprove and chasten, to love people into heaven. I'm praying it's not going to be that love is love. No, we are going to love you with the truth of God's word. So amen. We are now going to come into agreement with what RIT Laquita has taught. Our Pastor Seaman has given commentary. We are going to say in this song, let the church say amen, because we agree.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church, say.
In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and our soon coming King. In Acts chapter 1 and verse 8 reads, "But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth." And in Acts chapter 2, verse 1 through to 4 reads, "And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance." Happy Pentecost Sunday. Our announcements for the week beginning May 19th are as follows. We have our youth program, Champion Kids for Christ, on Saturday mornings at 10 a.m. This is led by RIT Stacy Can. We invite your children, their cousins, and friends to join us as we are building young soldiers for Christ. Also on Saturdays, we have our Beacons Bible Study, BBS, at 5:30 p.m. And this is led by our pastor, Reverend Randy Lightborn. Next Saturday, May 25th, we will be studying Ephesians chapter 5, part 1. You are also welcome to join us in our Sunday evening praise and worship service, which begins at 7 p.m. UK time, 3 p.m. Bermuda time, and 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Let us come together to worship, to honor, and to magnify our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We invite you to continue to worship with us today as we support our Swim family in their Sunday evening praise and worship service at 10 p.m. UK time and 6 p.m. Bermuda time. The speaker, Brother Paul Kiprotich of Nanyuki, Kenya. His sermon topic, Faith Over Fear. Next Sunday, our pastor, Randy, will be ministering from the sermon topic, Why Worship and Praise God Changes. Scripture text, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 1 through to 4, and verses 13 through to 18. Are you hungry for the Word of God? Please subscribe to our Swim TV Bermuda YouTube channel. You most certainly will be blessed by the services and teachings. You can also catch the replay of our sermons and our Swim family sermons on Real Knows Real, Apple, Google, or Spotify podcasts. Share this as well with your family, friends, and colleagues so that they too can be blessed by the Word of God. Please feel free to reach out to us on Beacons for Christ Ministry UK at gmail.com or on our mobile, +44 795 157 1671. May you continue to have a blessed Pentecost Sunday. Grace and peace be multiplied unto you. Blessings abound.
Hallelujah, Heavenly Father. Father, we thank you for that powerful word that we received from you on this Pentecost Sunday. Father, we thank you for our speaker, RIT Laquita. We thank you for using her today. We thank you that she has allowed herself to be in a position to be used by you, Father. Father, we thank you for your Holy Spirit that guides us, the comforter, the comforting Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We know it's impossible to do without you, Father. And through the power of the Holy Spirit, Father, we know that we can continue to be the beacons of light that you have called us to be, Father. Hallelujah. Father, I ask that you bless all that have heard this word today, Heavenly Father, that we may be encouraged and inspired to allow our lights to shine, especially in these times that we're living in, Father. Father, we ask that you continue to grow us, and we continue to spend that time in their prayer rooms, Heavenly Father, so we continue to grow. We ask in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother RJ. Thank you for that powerful closing prayer. Let us recite together Beacons for Christ, the Kingdom Affirmation, Hold the Line. We are Beacons for Christ. Off the beams of our Father, we shine. Battling against the spirits of darkness, we hold the line. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, We align anchored in his strength. We hold the line. Our branches will bear kingdom fruit. We are attached to the holy vine. We remain resolute in kingdom purpose. We hold the line. We take spread the gospel to all mankind, steadfast, unshaken, and kingdom assigned. We are beacons for Christ, and we hold the line. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So at this time, I just want to thank each of you for joining us in this powerful service, right from the intercessory prayer straight through to the closing prayer. We thank you for just availing yourself to the Holy Spirit's leading, because yes, it's the Holy Spirit that led you here to fellowship with us. And on top of that, with the powerful message that RIT Laquita gave us, food for thought, nuggets, and just that encouragement, I just want to end our service. If she doesn't mind, I am going to read something that really hit me with what she said. We are beacons of light, empowered by God in a dark and perishing world. So we walk fearlessly because our God has overcome this world. Hence, we arise and walk victoriously in the light, manning the beams of our lighthouse with our shields up, hallelujah, and we are holding the line. We are beacons for Christ, hallelujah. This is the part. Battered at times, tired at times, yes, we are challenged at times, but we let our light shine. So I encourage you today and this week going forward, let your light so shine before man that they would see your good works, but glorify our Father in heaven. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, bless you. Blessings abound.